Today, MasterClass lesson is about creating testimonial in a section.
Okay, the next section that we will be doing is section 4, and I think it's much easier than the last section that we have. Anyway, if you look at it, this is basically it's a testimonial, and you have, first of all, you have one row section, second row section, three column, and bottom there is a space, and the top also there is a space. This is where we done it before, right? And then come down here. So remember, the layout is very simple: space, one row column, three column, and the space. That's how we're going to design. Then look at the design page. Now we go into design page. This is what we done. And the next thing we do is, remember, we create one space for the spacing on the top, tracking the widget. That is the space we drag and you just drop there. Okay. Then the second is also second row. It's a title. Right. Then we put in a title page. Okay. That will be the title. Okay. We're going to move into the center. And the next row, right, look at it, you will see another row. We're going to add in, that will be icon. So we got to set this page here. This one is set in another page, another row. And this part is actually an icon. Okay, where do we get the icon? Very simple, go to widget. And we go to icon, right? Okay, when we look at icon, we click the button, we drag the icon inside here. Okay, you look at the star, but we do not want the star, we want the quotation. So we go back here, we type in quote, right? Quotation, Q-O-A, then you'll find the quotation mark on the right. They call it quotation on the left, quotation on the right. So what we want it to do, we click here, we insert. That's it, you are done. The next one we talk about, if you look at here, we have actually three column here with the testimonial. Right. So what we need to do is we need to add in the three column here. Now we add in three column. Put in the three column, and each column will have the testimonial, right? So where do we look for the testimonial? Basically, very simple. We go back to the widget part, and we type in testimonial. If we can't find, then we just type in testimonial. So you can see the testimonial page, right? Just drag one of this and just place it inside there. Okay, you will see that there is the text content, the name and the images, and the designer name. Let's look back at the main page here. Okay, the content, the image and the name, right? So it's a very straightforward and that we are doing it. And okay, let's look at the image. See what image we have here. I think we have some image here. This is the image. Okay, we just insert the image. Straightforward. And then what is the name? Very simple. We copy the name, copy it, then we put in the name. Okay, this is the name of the thing. Okay, the name is here, right? So we just paste. Hey, sorry, I think it's the wrong one. Sorry, that's the wrong. We go back. Just refresh it, never mind. So what we do here, actually the designer, the name, I think we copied the wrong one because we did not use the the proper name. We can type in the name if you want to. Okay, Sophia Grant. Okay, S-O-P. Okay, basically is S. Okay, capital S. O-P-H-I-A, right? Sophia think the last word here is wrong here. Okay, so you have Sophia Gran. Okay, Sophia Gran. Okay, so G-R-A-N-T. Okay, that's the name. Now look at it. Here they didn't have the title. Okay, so if they don't have a title, we just basically very simple. We remove this title name here. So we just delete it off. Here, that is the title. So we just delete it. Okay, so there's no title. So now come to the text. This text here, I think you have to set the text differently. So what we do is basically we copy the text here. Whole lot. Copy. Go back. Here we change the text. Completely delete the old one. Put in the new text. I think this is the color code I've been putting in. No, sorry. Color code, no, here. It's actually color code here. So what we do is this one. Let me see what I can copy here. Copy. It doesn't, it cannot work on copy. Maybe. Okay, maybe here. Let me see, I can copy the whole thing just to show you. Content, go back here. Here probably I can copy from here. Okay, this is where I copy. Okay, copy, go back here. I paste over it. Okay, that is done. I could lightly walk. See whether I'm correct. I could, but okay, that is correct. So this is the content, but the content is, ours one is quite big, so we need to adjust it. Color will be black. Okay, color be black. Okay, let's look at the typographer. I think it's Roberto, if I'm not mistaken. R-O-P-O, Roberto. Okay, this will be a Roberto size, and the size will be around 16. I think it's about 16. See whether that's correct. Yeah. So this is about the size. Basically, this is the size. Alright. So if we look at it, the size about this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. Let's go back here. 2, 3. So we increased a little bit of the size. Because sometimes it's differently. 2, 4, it's a bit more. 6, 2, 4, 6. I think we have to change a little bit on the weightage. Okay, the weight, maybe I put around 400. Chain width 400. So the size smaller a little bit. Okay, let's see. Is that right? Move it a little bit more. This will look better, right? So it's all a matter of adjusting it yourself and everything. Okay, now we have the, we keep it to standard. So what I do is, all I need to do is to duplicate again very fast. I just duplicate the column, come down, then I delete one column out. Delete one column. So you have the two. So I go and duplicate another one, come out, so I delete the last one. So I have already had three column here, straightforward. The only difference here is the text, the image, and the name. Okay, let's look at this one. Right, the content can be different. Maybe this one, if I look at it, I will take the content. That's the content. Let me see. Okay, that is the content. I just copy it and bring it across. Right, so this is the one that I'm doing, so I just paste it over. Okay, so that's the content. So the image, right, image, I can change to this. I just insert, right, so the name, I change it. What's the name? Let's see, what's the name? James. His name is James. Just copy his name. Copy. Bring back here. Simple, and then I just change the name and paste. Then second one I done. Okay, now I'm gonna go for the third one. Third one, let's look at the content. Let's look at the content. Same thing. Third one, look at the content. So I just take the content out of there, copy. Then I go back here, I take the content, I just erase this one completely, delete it all. Then I paste it. Right, so I got the content. Now, okay, the picture. Picture can be different. Alright, let's look at the picture. Then this is the picture, then I copy and I insert. Done. Now is the name. Right? Okay, it's a name. Now basically it's a name. Right, let me see, it's the name Amy. So I look at the name called Amy Winter. Copy, paste, right? Amy Winter. So it is a name and I just paste. So basically this is almost done. We had the spacing on top, we had the title, or the title I didn't change it. Okay, let's look at what is the title there. Let's look at the title. This is the title that we had. The title is this part, I think we changed already. Anyway, but the title is in black, I think. Sorry, it's in white. So before we do this, otherwise we can't see. Let's do the color first, the background color. So if you look at the background color, it'd be blue. Right, I think this is a code. I just copy the code. Okay, I just copy the code. If I know the code or any color that you want to put in. So now we go back to the background color setting. Okay, classified, classic. Alright, color. I paste the code there. Okay, that's one part. But don't forget this one also the same. I need to change the color. Right, so go back, style, classic, color, paste the code, same, second one, same, style, alright, classic, color, paste, same, so now come this one, right, so this one, simple, style, classic, color, and paste, done. You notice all this become black and you can't see, never mind. We come back later. So the last one here, oh, we miss out one thing here, which is the, bottom spacing. So we add in the bottom spacing, right? We drag, and we drag the spacing here. Okay, spacing is there. So we change the color, same thing, classic, color, paste the code, done. So we already have this, but okay, when it comes to, we can adjust the spacing if you want to. But anyway, leave it alone first. Now let's look back the main page here. This one, the background is white. Okay, this one, the wording is white. So let's do the first one first. Let me see. Now this one, the text is white color. So we go back here and we look at text color, white. Oh, sorry, this is white. I'm doing my own. Okay. So now we look at this. The text is white. Okay. Style, white. Okay. So you can see the white color. The code, right? About the code. Right, so the code is also white, not blue. Let's see here. Let's go out and then I want the text to change. This is the icon, color, primary color, white. So it changed to white. So all these texts here are white. Right, so go back. Text color, white. I believe it's white. Yep, I think so. Let me see whether it's white. Yes, correct. Oh no, black, sorry. It is not white. But anyway, did the wrong one. Okay, so let's see. Now, before we go into jump into the color coding here, because this background is white. Okay, so the background is white, then we need to do some setting here. We must look at the, now we have to look at column. The column background is white. So we go down here, we look at column. Classics, white. So this is white, so you can't see your wording white. And we need to look at the text. Okay, this is the text, so this is where the element is. So we look at the text color must be in what? Let me see, what color is it? Black, okay. Text color is in black, so we choose black here. Darker black, okay. Okay, I think it's the wrong one, maybe. See, I'm remembering the right one. Okay, this is the right one, the testimonial. Style, text color is black. Yep, okay, darker black. Okay. Actually, by right, I should done this and then I copy it over. That'd be more easy. Right, okay, so basically this is how you work. And the same thing to this one. Right. When you look at column, you want column to change to white. Okay, column, white. Okay, but this one is already changed a little bit, but then we still want to be darker color. So this is style, text color, black. Okay, this one is another one. Background, let's load the column. Background is white. Okay, so what we do here is okay, let's see, column, all right, this one here, background white, so here white, but the text, you see the text element here, the text will be let's see, the text will be, should be dark color. Okay, done. So right, so this is done. And if you look at the basic thing, the even the name is in black. Let's change the name into black color here. See, that is the title image. You see, okay, see a name, go to style name, all right, color black. If it's black now, okay, is it now? Okay, black. So the same thing to here, right? All right, then you go to the name, black, it's in black. Okay, done. Same thing to here, and you look at it. All right, look at it. The name is in black. Okay, we choose black. Okay, it is done, right? So now you notice that there is a gap between here and there, right? You look at it, that is a gap. One way to do is, all right, you can actually fill up this gap with a blank. Let me try this out. All right, try it out. I have to have a gap, right? By right, I should have a gap, but the layout of this slightly different, because you look at the layout, right, layout, and they say that the box content column gap default, so I say extended, see whether I can extend, there you are, extended, but however it is extended, but I can't see the blue thing here, right? Okay, one way to do, if you can shift, you see, you can shift, you can move about, right, which I don't think I will do. So another way to look at this is basically how do we go, right? So very simple, if I duplicate one more thing here, if I duplicate this, right, you give me a space which I delete all this, let me see, I don't need this, I delete it all. So you have a gap here. I can narrow it down, right? to the size that I know, and I change the color here, right? Okay, I change it to whatever color okay you want to do. Let's say, let's check what color is this. Let me go back here. I check the color, so I get a code. Right, I'll get a code, copy. So what I do now is I change the column color. Okay, I go back here. I take this column. Column color. I take it color. Okay, it's a blue. So I paste it. There you are. See what I mean? Right, so this is basically how I set here another one. Okay, let's duplicate this one again. Duplicate. Right click, duplicate. So you have another one, so I don't need this. I delete it. Okay, so you left a column. So the column size will reduce. I have to reduce it. Generally, if you look at this column here, maybe you have to move this a little bit. And then here, it's a sign 29. So you got to do some calculation. And how you do it. Okay, we leave a gap. This one is also around that size. And then we leave a gap. So basically, it's all we're talking about adjustment. So here, this column here, I add in style, color, okay, put the code here, done. So all here is done in such a way that you can play around with this system, right? Adjust the size that you want. Maybe this one is too big, and then we move it around, and then we move this a bit, and then basically this is how you can set it up. On the total of this, the top one, if you think is too small, you go back here. It is actually a spacer, and the spacers you can change. Let's look at the layout. Okay, you can look at the spacing. If I click onto this, no, I click on here. It's a space. Right now it's 50. I can change it to even higher, more. The bottom spacing, the same thing. Right. So layout. So let me see here inside, then I can change it to more. Okay, that's basically how you set up the fourth section to learn how you can create the fourth section with this. And then when you update it and you can see, okay, we can view the whole lot. Okay, you can see here exactly the same, but of course this one you need some adjustment and things like that. Okay, thank you.
Well, we have come to the end of lesson number 4. Subscribe to my YouTube channel to learn more about landing page, blog posts, e-commerce and other animated video effects on your website. I would like to thank you for watching my video. Hopefully, you can enjoy and learning more in the near future. Thank you.